Good afternoon, viewers. I'm just outside Buckingham Palace. This is a pre-warning. 2 o'clock, the fracking nanas are going to be here for their Tabards and Tiaras event to try and persuade the lady that lives in there to go along with what the next Labour government is going to do and ban fracking. Fracking is about to start up in Yorkshire and Lancashire. All over the place, they're poised to poison our water supplies all over the country. And we have to stop this evil scourge. The fracking nanas will be here at Buckingham Palace from 2 p.m. So spread the word. Good afternoon, viewers. This is a T-minus 30 warning. T-minus 30 warning. The fracking nanas arriving at Buckingham Palace. So tune in from 2 o'clock. So I'll get another little mention out there to get people watching. The nanas are approaching. Coming up the mall.
Arriving at Buckingham Palace.
Sorry about the wobble, I'm doing a zoom at the moment. Hi UK watching. Here are the nanas turning up for their little tea party at Buckingham Palace. I wonder if they'll be invited in. Just a little wobble, I haven't got my tripod and it's on a bit of a zoom at the moment.
My favourite!
Now they're getting cross over there.
They're going to the place where they can't get off.
This comes on the day after the historic resolution at the Labour Party conference that if when they get elected into power, they will ban fracking. So that's really, really good news for anyone investing in fracking, isn't it? And anyone that invests other people's money in fracking, like pension funds, I think needs to have criminal charges against them. Tina Louise calls the anti-fracking protesters the investor removal team. You would have to be completely insane to now invest in fracking the UK. Completely, certifiably insane. If you have money in a pension fund, ask your pension fund provider if any of it is invested in a fracking company and scream blue murder if it is, because you will lose it. You will lose every penny. This is just a way to poison our water by evil, evil people. Keeping our water and our air quality safe is an issue that every sane human being can agree on. I think they're taking a bit of a detour going down to those traffic lights. That's the maximum zoom I can do. They're quite a long way off, crossing the main road. That's the road down to Victoria. They're now coming up, approaching the palace. Try and get a bit of a point of rest on. There we go, that's a bit more stable. Bit of a dull afternoon here in London, but it's warm still. We'd have had an absolutely crackingly warm September. Though nothing whatsoever to do with man-made climate change, because that's a whole fraud as well. If you watch my previous broadcast at the London Climate Conference. The issue here is pollution. Fracking causes pollution to our water, to our air. It's an absolutely demented way to force the Earth to give up methane that it really doesn't want to give up. There are plenty of natural gas fields where the methane is desperate to come out, where it's under high pressure. Why not use those? Why do we have to ruin the world? But even with naturally flowing gas, there's a problem of being too greedy. In Groningen, in the Netherlands, they have the issue at the moment where they're just trying to extract far, far too much from their gas field over there that's been very productive for decades. And of course, with the release of pressure in all the rocks, they're getting earthquake problems. In Holland. Really, once that sort of thing starts, you should give up on that particular reserve. You can't inflict that on other people. We have too much of misery being inflicted on other people for the profit of the few. It has to stop. Here they come. Cut the zoom now again, have a bit less wobble. No, CO2 is not a warming gas, whoever said that. If you watch my broadcast from the London Climate Conference, that has been absolutely disproved. There is no experimental evidence for it. You can't prove it in the laboratory. It has no effect on the climate. Climate change is caused by other things, like long-term solar cycles. The Earth itself belches out absolutely colossal amounts of methane through deep sea methane seeps and undersea volcanoes. There are many, many megawatts. I think one of the things that came out of the conference is that in the deep sea trenches, the very abysmal ocean, there are something like 56,000 methane seeps. That are releasing methane at the equivalent of megawatt power stations each. And this is causing the planet no harm whatsoever. It's been going on since the formation of the Earth. In fact, it supports a very diverse ecosystem of methanogenic bacteria and a whole food chain that feeds on them. That does very well out of it. This is life that we didn't know about until about 20 years ago. We had no idea about it because it's in the very, very deep ocean where the water pressures are absolutely insane. We've actually got very low levels of atmospheric CO2 at the moment because so much of the too much of it has been locked up by the sort of natural locking up of organic matter in things like coal seams. Plants have evolved to be extremely efficient. They're working with very, very low concentrations, being able to pull it out of the atmosphere. But if there was more CO2 in the atmosphere, plants would find it a lot easier to grow. This isn't just a theory. When I started thinking about what I wanted to do, I was thinking about going into the wine and spirits trade. And I read about whiskey distilleries up in Scotland. Whiskey distilleries tend to have very productive greenhouses, growing lots of tomatoes and the nice things for the staff, fed off the CO2 from the fermentation, because it makes everything grow so much quicker, even in Scotland. So a slightly higher CO2 level would actually do no harm at all. In fact, there has already been a measured greening of the planet from slightly elevated CO2 levels. Yes, the reason for anthropomorphic, as the posh term is it, human moderated climate change, is that the people in power can use it as an excuse to levy taxes, to curtail people's freedoms, to tell people where they can and cannot live, all that sort of thing, all this sort of fascism. And global warming is a big part of Agenda 21. It is a big part. What we've got to do is separate pollution, which is obviously bad, and fracking is a major source of pollution if you let it happen. And CO2 being a pollutant, which it patently is not. There is no great danger to methane leaking into the atmosphere either. As I said before, there is enormous amounts of it leaks out from the Earth itself, mostly underwater, but also from land volcanoes as well. Huge amounts of it. It's just a fundamental part of the structure of the Earth. Yes, pollution is the thing we have to tackle. They're misdirecting us. This is a big con. Pollution. I'll go down. I'm going down. Let's go down. We're getting nearer to the singing. Here we are.
No,
a bit cold for that.
I'm willing to hang out with the Lord, but he asked where we were going, and I said, no, we're staying here. Mm-hmm. And he said, can we sleep till when? And I said, overnight. And he said, where we sleep, I want to show that we come business. This isn't an easy day out for
I got a note. Sorry, folks, I put a microphone in front of the TV. She's away.
Hi, Mark.
Hi. Okay.
I got a note from the Lancashire Police this morning saying, hey, how's it going? What are your plans? Anything happening in Lancashire when the decision comes, which could be any day. I think it was maybe a hint that it might be today or tomorrow. I don't know.
While we're all away.
While we're all away. Very useful. How you doing? So, for me, won't it? Most of us will end up going home tomorrow because we've got a busy week ahead. We've got Sunday, the Birmingham for the Conservative Party conference. Wouldn't miss the chance to shout at her for the world. So it'll be a day. We've got nice cakes. We've got Tiaras arriving shortly. Tis Tabards and Tiaras.
All right.
I feel we're letting the side down, lacking a tiara. Are we going to do our happy day one?
No, not right away.
No? Okay. Where is this? And I need a copy. Yeah, that's what we need. Coffee and cake and chili. And there was a tea trolley.
Are you going to do it?
Unfortunately, it got
pushed to pieces. When you do Alicia, where have you been? I've been running here.
I couldn't do that. We got this.
Where have you been?
We've been to London to petition the Queen.
Nanisha, what did you there?
It said it's not Mrs. May, it's Teresa, which works better. Yeah. These are our two songs. And we came up with a new one on the steps of Liverpool the other day. I saw a tweet, yeah, and the tweet said, I just walked past a bunch of women and they're singing melodically on the steps of the Labour Party.
Yeah, I thought that was in tune, they said.
In tune! And only two of us can sing.
Well, where are the nanas? The nanas should be there.
So the nanas went down to Buckingham Palace with tea and cake and meeting their mouths, asking the Queen to give us her backing to save our future and say no to fracking. And then the other ones to that tune. Can you sing it? Sing it with me, Fox.
No.
The nanas have only got one goal. Stop fracking before it ends us all.
The Tories, they tell gay stories. But no one believes them at all.
Teresa
has only got one goal to frack us. But we're not playing ball.
We're mamas, grandmas and others.
Protecting the future for all.
We'd make a lousy harmony.
More rehearsals. The
cop said, good cop, bad cop, and apparently he's
bad. On his mic.
Look at him. He went like this, didn't he?
Yeah.
Tina, what do you think about the Labour Party resolution to ban fracking?
There's no Labour Party resolution. It has not been
passed. No, not yet.
It hasn't been passed by conference.
All right.
I said the same thing said when the Lib Dems came out with it the other day. Which is welcome to the party. You're 5 years late.
Yeah.
The Green Party's been here with us from the start.
Yeah.
Liberal Democrats just came on board and I asked, is this because you have just come to the realisation of how dangerous this industry is for our communities or simply that it's politically expedient? I don't really care. I'll take anyone on board we can get. But I would like it to be for the right reasons.
Yes.
When we watched Jeremy Corbyn speak in Liverpool the other day, in all honesty, he spoke for a good 20 minutes. It appeared to be from the heart. He had no script. He winged it.
Yeah.
And I watch a lot of speakers, and I quite had a lot of faith in him. I do not have faith in his party, but I do think the man meant well. So when that one man said, I will get Labour to ban fracking.
Yeah.
That's just like having just got you or you or you to say I will ban fracking. To me, I am as jubilant and a new incomer to the fight as I am if he was anybody. There is no cult of Corbyn. There is a sensible man saying sensible things amidst a party in mayhem. But you know what? We'll just take it. In the end, it's air and water, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, everybody requires air and water. Yeah. So there is no one who will not stand beside us at some point when they realise the truth of this industry.
Yeah, it's just insane trying to squeeze resources out from where they don't want to come.
Exactly. And also there's the having the ability to fight every arena. We fight it with activist groups, we fight it at the camps, we fight it in communities, in council offices, in planning rooms, at the palace and in politics. We take every arena and place ourselves as activists there. And then we infest everything. We're like a lovely little disease of nana. Infested with a nana. Anyway, I'm going to go up and see the mother bit, because that's the bit that really applies, I think. Yeah, the woman who's facing, and each side of this, it represents justice, anyway, agriculture, motherhood, victory.
That's it, the nanas are here, we're live stream later, we're trying to save me back, looking at
And we've got cakes to eat. Come on.
Mm.
Let's get down to the serious stuff.
Oh yes. Welcome. You join us at Buckingham Palace. New viewers. Well, the nanas are here.
So you look at the mother bit, but taking our bits.
Ladies? Janelle, Where do you have to be?
Yes, just a reminder what I said before, if you have a pension, please, please contact your pension provider and make sure they are not investing in any company involved in fracking. If they are, then make a really big, big fuss. Get them to divest from fracking. Your pension will not be safe if you put it in this crackpot, insane scheme. Get your pension provider to divest from fracking. Anyone that now invests in fracking, I think, should be invested as a criminal matter. This is a conspiracy to poison our air and our water.
Most of the time, funds, employment, family time, 5 long years, you know?
There's a big action also coming up shortly against Barclays Bank, who invest a lot in fracking. They need to be made to change their minds and stop. And pressure needs to be put on Barclays Bank to change their minds. So if you're a Barclays customer, please write to your bank manager, phone up your bank manager, ask your bank manager when Barclays is going to stop investing in fracking. And say you will consider moving your account somewhere else if they don't.
We're not allowed to have that. For a quick photo opportunity, you might be all right. Yeah. But don't do anything with the banners too soon. Please don't.
As the
bring coffee. Bring coffee.
Yeah, bring
now.
Coffee.
Bring coffee.
Yeah, Londoners.
Coffee.
Londoners.
Coffee. Bring an
call earth. Out to Londoners. Bring coffee. Yeah. That's the place. That's Lizzie's gaff. Does the flag mean that she's actually there? I think it does. Flag flying. So she's actually in there, somewhere. Would she really want her country riven by earthquakes, with farmland poisoned, water poisoned, air poisoned, like it already has been, provably, in large parts of America and Australia? These are big countries. To some extent, they can survive the damage better than we can. We are a small and very crowded island. There is absolutely no place for fracking in this country. It's been prevented for 5 years so far. It needs to be prevented permanently.
I'm going to meet George. So really, not only is the Tiaras Foundation working with a million little pairs, and look to my dear, and how can we
The pressure needs to be relentless. We need to stop. They are thinking that this criminal government of Theresa May can get away with destroying our country with earthquakes, with poisoned water, with poisoned air. They are criminals. They are absolute criminals if they think they can get away with this. What we could do with now is a bit of sunshine. Very overcast here today, but warm enough. Are you an anti-fracking pigeon? He's an anti-fracking pigeon, that one. He's heard there's going to be some cake, I think. So we've got the press here, got cameras and big microphones and everything, that's good. I wonder if the Queen's going to come out and meet us. Because that would be the result we want, really. A statement from Her Majesty to say that no, absolutely no fracking in her country. This is absolutely criminal. The people of this country have, by various protests and camps and other actions, stopped this for 5 years now. We need to stop it permanently. No more pissing about with this. These criminals must not be allowed to get away with it just because they have links to government. To the criminals up in Whitehall. They cannot be allowed to cause earthquakes, to poison our water, to poison our air. Which have all happened in Australia, in America. Oklahoma never used to have earthquakes. It has several a week now. There was a big one a couple of weeks ago that seriously damaged buildings, including, ironically, collapsing a bank. A bank completely collapsed.
One goal, stop fracking before it ends us all. The Tories, they tell great stories. But no one believes them at all.
Theresa
has only got one goal, to crack us, but we're not playing ball. We're mothers, grandmas and others, protecting the future for all. Oh, Nana Cher is wonderful. It's full of fighting nanas. Oh, Nana Cher is wonderful.
Oh, Nana Cher.
Oh, Nana Cher.
It's wonderful.
It's wonderful. Oh, Nana Cher is wonderful. It's full of fighting nanas. Oh, Nana Cher is
Hello, you're our hero. I love you.
Oh, hello.
We're not allowed to love you if you're independent. They'll say you're not.
I'm really sorry, I have to run up to
I know. It was very nice to meet you.
This is my protest. This is my protest. Yeah. Half an hour and no cake.
No cake? Oh, this is serious.
Half an hour I've been here. I'm going to have a sit down, lie down protest.
They've probably got some really nice cakes in there, you know.
We've got the best cakes. Have you seen them? They're awesome.
Oh, ooh.
Yeah, of course you can.
Yes, stick around, people. You'll see some really amazing cakes. As it comes out half an hour, I will be right back.
On the back of this world where we live, there should be more above. Bring me sunshine, bring me solar, bring me love.
Welcome back to the Fracking Nanas, who have arrived outside Buckingham Palace and will be staying for some considerable time. So if you're in London, come on down. Come on down and support them.
But here's a day to support the Fracking Nanas, wonderful Fracking Nanas. Yeah. Yesterday, Scarborough.
Yeah, that's a gorgeous gate over there.
By saying it's one nanny to another, I implore you to protect their future, health and beautiful Lancashire countryside where we live. Fan Fracking now. Respectfully, Nana Bex.
Everybody was there. People in Thailand were being Washington, Australia, Canada. There were a lot of teeter. This is the report that we're giving to the Queen. We've come down specifically to deliver it to her. It's a peer-reviewed study by a professor who came to Lancashire and studied the impacts of shale gas on a community before it even gets fracking. The impacts of the way that the companies pressure you, they split your society, they divide your community, and it's a lot of stress and a lot of pressure for a community, and that's before they even get started. So we're going to be sending this to the Queen, and we hope she'll take the time to read it and understand a bit about why we're here and why we're so deeply concerned.
Actually, it's not me, really.
Foxy put me off. Oh, wait, no. Okay.
Welcome, viewers. You join us at Buckingham Palace.
I am Tina Robbery. I give the report.
Can you get it,
on the residents group, and she's produced a report on the impacts of fracking before it arrived, how they impacted with the way that they were pressuring communities, the division, the scout huts, the sponsorships, the division they've caused, the phony public meetings and all that stuff, and the health impacts on the local community who have had to fight them already. So yes, that's a really good report. You'll get me probably, but I'm literally just off.
Fantastic. Brilliant.
Are we addressing it? A report,
Thank you very much. Bye bye.
Right.
Nice background.
So it looks like they're here for a long stay. Sammy.
Hi, how's it going?
Hi.
Hiya, how are you?
Yeah. I'm okay, yeah.
Good. Come down and support the nanas.
Yes, yeah.
We just came for the cake.
Oh, right.
Yeah,
yes, I've seen the pictures of the cakes.
Oh, I didn't see pictures of the cakes.
Yes, they tweeted out pictures of the cakes. Very regal.
Come on, Tommy. Get my good side, yeah?
Yeah, okay. You chose to call me Nana Mischief. You want me to behave?
Why is your
Well, Tina Louise is just over at the gate at the moment, just finding out what will happen when if we finally deliver the report for the Queen, which was explained earlier. See if they'll accept it. I think they're going to be arsy about it. Let's go zoom in.
Thank you. adult tubes. Okay. And they've got a manufacturer in
Excuse me, would you know what acts is being planned for the Tory conference that you'd like people to come along and get involved in Birmingham? Do you know?
No,
no. Okay, well, Tina probably knows.
Tina?
Yes.
Yes, I'm right down on the south coast.
So right.
Let's get the important thing. Let's get this show on.
Have we not got any masks or anything?
That's the Queen where a nearest supermarket is. Probably Harrods. Just sums up what's completely insane about the fracking. Why it should be allowed on such a small island as ours. It's just down to greed and corruption. That's all, greed and corruption. Or maybe even more sinister, that they really are trying to kill us. Oh, here comes Nina Louise. Yeah, it's very difficult to remove contaminants from water once they're in there. And fresh water is one of the finite resources we have on Earth. Once it's been spoiled, it's been spoiled. It's much more precious than methane. There's plenty of methane. What did they say?
No. You'd have to have posted that in. I said it's an emergency chances are we're going to get a decision within the next day or so. We did alert her a week ago, and we did say we'd be here, and all we want is for her to take a report. So the only way she'll read the report is if you put it in the post, then it goes through to get searched. I said, what happens if I just pop it under the gate? It'll get binned. Can you not just take it? No, it's not allowed. And she was really nice, and she went well within her job. But, you know, don't forget that we don't expect to necessarily win at everything we do, but we expect to try every democratic avenue we can get.
Can you do it recorded delivery?
Yeah, probably. And we will, but still, in the end, we need to show it.
Yeah.
We need to see how we, what we can do and how we can make the system work for us. Or if we can't, prove the point that the system doesn't work for us.
Yeah.
Which sadly is looking more and more like the case.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you have to keep on trying.
Yeah. Hungry pigeons. Yeah. So the Queen has to put up with a private company delivering something to her when we were right there at her gate.
With royal written all over.
Yes, that should be removed.
What a sham.
Yeah. Let's just say the used to be Royal Mail.
Yeah,
the
ex-Royal Mail.
Yeah.
Julie has it.
The mail that was royal once.
Yes, yes.
You get everywhere. And you have all the Tabards.
So the Queen does not accept deliveries to her house of mail items unless they come by the not anymore Royal Mail. Isn't that ridiculous? The not anymore Royal Mail has to deliver things to that building. You can't hand deliver things to that building, they won't accept them. A fucking farce, isn't it? It really is. It's the case of denial. She doesn't want to accept it. She doesn't want to have to do anything. It's denial. In denial. Not just in Buckingham Palace, in denial. And her flunkies protect her from reality. That there's a criminal government who want to poison us. There is so much evidence, such an enormous amount of evidence, that fracking is really, really bad. Why are we even having to do this? Oh, it looks like it's coffee time. Oh, you got your coffee?
No, it's empty.
Oh, blimey.
Ham Lucas just gave me a present of a mug.
Oh.
So I'm halfway there. I just need coffee.
Yeah. Anybody listening that can come down with some coffee?
That's tea, isn't it?
Yeah. Who's that?
Who is it?
A nobody. Was it her trying to escape?
Bit of ignorance! Yeah.
Probably hiding on the bottom of the carriage or something. Ooh. Yeah, yeah. Ooh.
Yeah, definitely.
They look nice.
Yeah.
Mm.
What's this? I'm so hungry, I can't say it without lunch.
Lovely. Mm. He didn't film at the same time. Mm. Oh, Fox is getting his coffee.
Yeah, so rather than doing a big piece, I'd rather put a
Mm.
Like olive and a bit of
find it hard to drain when it's rocky, so a lot of water gets in
that area.
Decorated?
Oh, yeah, and they're underneath the whole lot of stuff in
there. Yeah, my coffee.
So, we're outside Buckingham Palace, the Queen is at home, but she won't accept the report that says these fracking companies are doing great harm to the communities where they're attempting to commit this crime before they even get to do it, by their bully tactics and the stress they're causing. Why do we allow these criminals to operate in our country? Oh, the pigeons are lining up with food around. It's very important, particularly you people who are customers of Barclays Bank, that you write to your bank manager, you mention it when you go in the branch, that you are not at all happy that Barclays is supporting fracking. There's going to be a big week of events against Barclays. If someone could put links to that in the chat, that would be very helpful. I think it's like half of October, sometime then, I'm not exactly sure. But anyone that is investing in fracking needs extreme pressure put on them to stop. This is not in the interests of the human race.
Thank you so much.
Yes, there'll be a week of action specifically against Barclays, sometime at the end of October, I believe. Because they are particularly keen in supporting the frackers, and they need to be shown the error of their ways. The same goes for anyone. If you have a pension, check with your pension provider that they are not investing in any company that is involved in fracking. They really have to stop. Pressure them to stop investing your money in anything to do with fracking. It is absolutely immoral that they're using your pension money to invest in this. And you won't get a return on your pension either, because it will fail horrifically in the end. There's no way this can be allowed to happen.
I think that's what it's there for.
Thank you, John O'Houston. There's a link, hag350.org. Just check the link in the chat for the action against Barclays. Please get involved with that. And also check any other place that your money is invested, either directly or indirectly. Check that they are not investing in fracking.
And
Yes, and there's a Facebook group, Boycott Barclays, as well. That's easier to for people that can't see the chat to go for. The Facebook group, Boycott Barclays. I'm going to take a quick break as there's not much happening at the moment and let my battery recover a bit because it looks like it's going to be a long day. Keep around and we'll be back soon. We're back with the nanas and the cakes are out. Ooh, scones.
Like one.
Oh, I'd love one, yes.
Yeah, we are nanas.
Oh, nice little scone. Mm.
This food, I can say it's food.
Mm-hmm. Scones.
Food.
Mm.
That's got jam.
Is it yours?
Yeah, that one. Oh, no, it wasn't. I'm just passing
it around. Yeah, protest with scones.
I have a mouthful. Sorry. How are you?
Mm.
Do you remember that picture of the IMT Narori with the pregnant belly? That's the baby that was behind my name.
Welcome back. Bit of a windy afternoon here. We're at the Victoria Monument, I think it's called, outside Buckingham Palace, where the nanas are here. I think they're planning to stay overnight, so if people want to join them off to work. Have a drafty evening on the steps. Nice bit of rousing singing. So her in there gets the message. Because she won't accept things delivered to the door.
So that's what we're going to
wait for this bloody cake. Let's wait for the cake.
They've got cakes, they're on their way.
Probably not, but sandwiches, hors d'oeuvres.
Hello. Beauty Womax is coming. And I'm going to throw off and leave this and go over there.
I'll keep broadcasting as my battery's last, but I do need someone to take over for the evening session because it won't last that long. Anyone else? I reckon 4 out of 5 adults in the UK have a smartphone now. It's all you need to do this. It's a smartphone and an external battery and a selfie stick. Well, the selfie stick's not essential. It just makes it easier to hold the phone for long periods. That's all you need. You eat through between half and a gigabyte of data a day doing this sort of thing. Most people have data plans with at least that in. I don't know if anyone's going to stream the Tory conference protests. I would guess they are. It seems to be a pretty big thing to miss. As we're just saying, 4 out of 5 people in the UK would be capable of doing this, holding up a phone and talking into it. All you need, really, the special gear, is an external battery, because otherwise your phone goes flat in about half an hour. You have to feed it from the external battery, and then you can broadcast for 5, 6, 7 hours if you're careful. And an external, a suitable external battery is about 10. So, if you've got a smartphone, there is no excuse for not doing this, really. You can do it. Everyone can meet the eyes and the ears of the internet. It's not special.
and do you need any help
When should people be meeting for that, Tina? The Conservative Conference thing.
Birmingham on Sunday. The Conservative Party Conference is a massive protest called by People's Assembly. We're going to be with the Fracking and the Climate Block, organised by Campaign for Climate Change. And I don't know where we're meeting or what time, but if you look up protest Conservative Conference.
Yeah.
Is he raging because he doesn't have cake?
He's getting cake withdrawal symptoms.
And so I think also People's Assembly are providing coaches from all over the country.
Right.
So we'll be there definitely. And that's on Sunday.
Right.
But we are very conscious that a decision for Lancashire will happen any day. Mm-hmm. And possibly during the Conservative Party conference. So what we've done is we've said that on the very first Saturday after that decision is announced, we'll gather on Preston New Road. Not just the local groups in Lancashire, there's 40 groups there, but we're calling on everyone in the country to meet us there. And if you can't meet us there, use the hashtags don't frack blanks and we said no. Post images of your group, yourself, on the event page on Facebook. And the event page I think is called it's called Lancashire Response.
Right.
Lancashire Response.
So okay.
So on that page we put all the details. So that would be really great because I think we're going to need everything we can get, because don't forget, this is the you don't know if you heard any questions the other night, and when any questions was on, the guy, the politician, was saying about Yorkshire that they've now got planning permission, and that in order to honour local democracy, we must allow this to proceed.
Bollocks.
Which, I'm sorry, if that's the case, then the fact that we have said no in Lancashire, then well, we must honour local democracy and we must honour the fact that we will not frack blanks then. So, you know, he totally contradicted himself, but, you know, it's to be expected.
Yeah, corrupt. They're all corrupt.
Anyway, right, stop filming when I eat.
Looks like it's going to come out bright. Certainly got a bit warmer, that's good. It's very important that people can get to Birmingham on Sunday. Tell these criminals where to get off. Is it time for another sing song now everyone's eaten?
I'm going to go to the hospital.
Yes, UK watching over that suspicion about Twitter for a long time, that you only see a small part of the tweets on any particular discussion. Because shows like the Richie Allen show, they say they get hundreds of tweets. Sometimes I see lots, sometimes I only see a few. I think it's just luck of the draw what Twitter server you're connected to. I started running my own blog recently, because at least I know what visitors I get and things like that. It's at deluxetech.co.uk. So if you want to go and follow that. We need to start moving away from these big corporates and start building our own internet. Lots and lots of independent sites. To some extent, back like how it used to be. Because less corporate control that way. More people arriving.
Yes. Yes.
We love you,
Lee. We love you.
Down the drain, mate. Down the fucking drain. Down the drain.
Yeah, if Twitter gets bought by one of the big corporates, it'll become even more useless. We need to go back to basics. Everyone needs to run their own blog, link to each other's stuff. Costs very little. Get me started about Turkey.
Houston, here.
Yeah, fine. Yeah.
You used to be on my Facebook, haven't
you? And Christian's friend.
Yeah.
I'm all about Martin. I know all about Martin. He's his video type.
Martin's given the gas
tester. Dog counter, yeah.
Yeah, I was just thinking, I'll work to where I'm.
Oh, the Tiaras are coming out. Will they be let in? It's a big soiree now.
I'm not sure what it is, but
never mind.
But each
lot of us have generally been like golden and as we test we're here today because in these 4 years, the what we did is we informed our counsellor, gave them information on the peer reviewed studies, and over 100 again. And the others are generally paid for. So we informed our counsellors of the things that they were denied. We've lobbied our MPs to try to get to work with the communities, and in the end, quite often found they only actually work for efficiency. It's been quite stroking work.
But it actually looks quite good.
And now we made a list, a checklist of all the things we did. And we got down to the very last thing, which is appeal to your body.
And that was the last thing. You see, for us, because we do this as grandmothers, we're here to defend our job. We feel that we like to think about our role as a grandmother. Not as a monarch or someone who's raised over things, but someone who, like me, has had children, and now children have had children, and therefore you're thinking longer term into the future. And so on the first press release we addressed Your Highness and Your Majesty and Mom, and on the second press release and from now on, we address you as the Grandmother Elizabeth, because to us that is her highest title and her noblest honor and her greatest obligation. It really is, you know. So, so we came today to deliver a report that's been done. It's the latest peer reviewed report, and it's actually about the UK fracking situation, even though it hasn't started covering it. But it talks about the impact on communities, the division within communities, the way that the companies operate and come in and try and win over businesses for supply chains and get landowners to up that their land. And it's already had an impact on our community. It's splintered people, house prices have dropped, people have lost sleep and lost homes, lost time. Yeah, quality time with family and kind of stuff. So yeah, so it was just really to do that, because we drew our decision on Lancashire where we said no last year, and now the decision is in Westminster, and they could overturn us any day now and say, yeah, we're going to count anyway. Where is local democracy? And so I think that we all fear what happens at that point. What do we become when all options of democracy have been removed? Where do you stand? And I don't think any of us are, but we needed to make sure that we hadn't missed anybody out in that democratic tweeting. So today we finish the democratic tour. It is, and we didn't want to make it light. This is not a two-party parliament. We will say no times we will see you. And this is just to show that we actually mean this. You can drag a grandma away from the family and all of these women away from their homes. It is not the intense, but we need her to know, and we need our government to know, we actually need this. You know, yesterday the Labour Party came out and said that if they became the government of the hour, they would ban fracking. So that means all opposition parties now oppose fracking. And the only people in this country that want it are Theresa May and her government. And you know, that seems crazy. Within our community, we know the citizens don't want it. Over in Yorkshire, where they granted a licence, 98.something% of the community said no, and but they stood with that 1.something% that said yes in the council. And you know, it's just, we just despair. But again, like I said, we try everything first before we then stand and wonder, is our democracy working for us, or is it working for
us?
And even if you don't succeed, at least we prove the truth, and that's the important part.
What did
Yeah, that's the amazing thing. I think that's like what really works for us. You know, we didn't ever, if you'd have described how the nannies turned out, you'd be like, oh, that's really clever. And you didn't know us. I didn't realise everything was a wing and a prayer, and it was made up on the spur of the moment, and you were lucky if anything happened. But it was just the right diversity of people, of types, that came together and then ended up being this amazing support. And you know, even when we sing or we create events, it is always harmonious and well attended. And it doesn't matter which mix of that, you get this way and that way, that time and that time. It doesn't matter. It always just works. And I think it's because you don't come from any other place other than the heart of I'm a grandmother, or I'm a mother, or I'm a sister, or an aunt, or I'm just someone who cares about you.
Exactly.
So I think because that purity of motivation keeps us very tight in our expectations and our attitude.
Instead, and say,
and the time things were sad, you know. My granddaughter started. That's okay, love. That's all right. It was very much a boys' club. And I'm not saying we'd be better, but I'm saying the system was when it has a harmony and a bit more balance. And I think there's a great deal that I see women do, the way they think and the way that the males in the groups think, and thinking, wow, that really works when we're all doing that together. Yeah, but when it's a male-dominated camp or a female-dominated action, sometimes you don't get that balance.
And the way they're doing it, the people that are like their rights are in there, they only take it.
So my granddaughter started school, high school, last week, and when I started this, she was 6 years old, and she was there, and she used to sit in the back of meeting and just, you know, write notes to herself and draw little pictures of what she thought fracking was, but really got the hang of it. And then, like last week, she started high school, and she's now this tall, and I realised, yeah, that wasn't really good, you know, and other than the things that she came in with me, I didn't really get to talk about. And that's a real sad lesson. On top of that, there are so many intrusions in your life. And you just learn to live with those. Like the fact that when we took the field in 2014, we went and held a space for 3 weeks. And it was all done very orderly. It was within the law in the sense that we section 6'd it. The grandmas took it, the nanas took it. We needed to alert the local community who were unaware that the field was. So it was a set 3 week occupation. It was done. We evacuated. We left the field on the 26th of August. And on the 27th, the company evicted us.
They deny everything that worked there, and it was left
so it wasn't damages, but I then got settled with a £55,000 legal fee because of the eviction that never really occurred. The judge asked the landowner, did you really incur all these costs? And the landowner went, no. And the judge said, is it quadrilla putting your case through?
And I said, yes.
Which point it made it impossible for me to cooperate, because A, I think it's an abuse of our justice system. B, what? I'm sorry, you want me to give money to the people I think are criminals, who I consider a danger? So no, I'm not going to do that. So we went to court and I wrote a letter to the judge and I said, I think that you should feel as angry with me at the abuse of justice that your court is going to lose and deter activists to show that if you dare to raise your head above the law, if you dare to stand up for what you know to be true or believe, if you don't get what your government does, you could be saddled with this huge debt and your property and you could lose your freedom. And this is what happened in the church. How do you let something that doesn't happen to grandma's We recommend to anybody watching this, just look at it. Just have a little look, because when we do a public meeting, we're now 500 people. And when we go to a community, we say this is the post of the back, and they all, and it's not a scaremongering, you don't see anything scary film. Look at the signs, ask yourself,
when they dispose of all that waste. What happens to the waste they've already left on the ground? 15-20 years from now, is that industry coming back and checking the integrity of what they left behind? Because they checked, they got it right. They didn't spend it green again. But deep down, there's now a hole that goes right through, like from where we are.
There's an impervious
Manchester Mall, and they drill through that. And so they go through the impervious, which is now no longer impervious, and they drill down like nearly 2 miles across the line. And apart from everything they send down, liquid, chemicals, sand, to pick up that with the current radioactive material, send down there, and the rest of it. It's a dangerous industry. And they burn off methane, destroys radioactive waste, risky groundwater, 500
gears
of crack. And have a huge amount of traffic on the road, but also more than that, and the pollutants in the air, which are travelling more underneath the heavens. You're also travelling in the air. One accident, and you cannot regulate against that. So why are we doing this when there is so much solar and tidal and wind and offshore? And why is our government not investing in that instead? This is a short-term industry. It lasts maybe 15 years. And what's more, what no one realises when they say we need to keep the lights on, is this industry does not come online for over 10 years. There's a great deal of infrastructure and pipelines that need to be built before it can even start contributing to the capital. So, you know, we're a long way off. And we see it as a constant scheme. It's there to bring in investors and take more money, but in the end, we're like investors get better. Look to America, Canada, Australia, Victoria. They just banned it in Victoria and Australia. And that was after a 5-year cross-parliamentary study that proved that for every 10 jobs you get in fracking, you lose 18 of that. So it is not a job winner, you know, this is a lie and a myth. But then you look at George Osborne, who pioneered this, and you say, hey, what does your father-in-law do? Oh, that would be Lord Howe, and he's a champion for the fracking sector, and he's also invested in the same firm. And then you look at Lord Brown, who used to be the head of Quadrilla Gas, used to be the head of the Department of Energy and Climate Change, and still had bearing influence on who was employed in there, because now that's been expanded in turn. And instead of caring about climate, now they just turn that into a business department. Everything's in the economy. You know, for people like us, we live in families and communities. We don't live in an economy. You know, an economy is not where you raise your children to thrive. You know, it should be a nimby. Backyards where the children live. Thank you. And they have everything.
Is Tina giving an interview? That is coming up to another half an hour. I'm going to take another short break, let the battery recharge a bit, because the mum keep going a bit longer than just letting it drain in one go. I'm at 60% at the moment, so there's still plenty left, but 10 minutes of not broadcasting, I'll let it recover a bit. So I'll be back in a little while.
Oh,
here's the famous cakes.
Fine, thanks. Ooh. They look absolute. I wish I'd have saved room for one of those.
Oh, I'll have one. These are the famous cupcakes, the famous Regal cupcakes. Yes. Offering any to her in there? Although you can't pass things through that gate. We can't pass the reporter through that gate. No. So we can't pass cupcakes through that gate either.
She doesn't know what she's missing.
No. There's the cupcake. Oh blimey, now I've got the situation where I'm filming and I've got to eat a cake with the strawberry on top.
Oh, this is going on, it's thrown everywhere.
That is one nice cupcake. See? Tea and cakes outside Buckingham Palace, and the Queen's not invited. So we'll need some people coming, need to come after work. It's at 3:30 at the moment. The nanas are intending to stay all night, if possible. So support, people coming along with hot drinks, and just your moral support, really. Head for Buckingham Palace after work.
It's
Right, I'm just going to have to stop so I can eat my cake. I'll be back in a minute. That was an awful amount of sugar. The tame pigeons. Queen's pigeons. Are you a queen's pigeon?
Looks like one of those scrawny little rug rats.
Doing very well at a protest, these pigeons.
Oh, look at Tommy the Tommy
the
queen.
No, right, it was a chaffinch last time, do you remember?
These pigeons love the cake.
Oh, you're clean. You must be out of our back.
Yes, it is.
Oh, it is. I think it is. Come on. It's a young one. He might be a wood pigeon. He's got confused. He's on the city pigeon lifestyle. Yeah, thank you for those links, UK watching. It's the pigeon feeding part of the protest now. The pigeons really like. They're very friendly.
Yeah, but they're still alive. Yeah. Oh, is.
You wouldn't trust rats to eat out of your hand, would you?
Yeah. If it was friendly, I would.
Yeah.
I'd just wash my hands after them.
Yeah.
Hi, they're alive.
Yeah.
Exactly, even if they're a bit scruffy. Yeah. I'm a bit scruffy myself.
I was going to say.
Oh, they're gone. Exactly. All animals matter. I don't care if you're scrubbing. Hey! Hello! I love these pigeons. Oh, the crazy little bugger. Oh, you got me.
Oh, nice one, Liz.
Don't leave one off the wall.
No, that's like full of slugs, right? And your kind of ones, the chickens, are there in big cages. Factory farming. Okay.
You could have two, haven't you? Hey, three!
So I just throw a big handful of crumbs on top of you right now?
On a hat? Put them in a hat?
Be nice. Watch the pigeons,
butter. So we're getting regal cakes.
Yeah. Send it to Rachel, Rachel makes the pigeons. That's it, hold it in between.
These pigeons will be set for the rest of the day.
Feed the birds, tuppence a bag, tuppence a bag.
They're going to be hyperactive pigeons after all that sugar. At least I haven't got teeth to rot.
No teeth, fuck off! Same as swearing, folks, stop it.
Got no teeth.
They're
right,
all the words that can be used instead of fuck off, right? Hey, woo! It's not
as effective sometimes, aren't
they? No, no.
There's so many birds. And they get so close to
me.
Oh, this is cool.
Good job. Good job. I like you.
So, you don't talk to me about
stuff. That's a pretty one, isn't it?
Yeah.
One at a time, you little buggers.
Yeah. Right. We're here at the Nana's tea party in Buckingham Palace. That was a little pigeon feeding interlude.
Your prince just turned up and said, keep you at home.
Yeah.
Nothing much is happening at the moment. I think we'll probably be having another sing-song soon. So, that's enough for now. Let the battery recharge a bit.
When I got up on Sunday, waiting for March to come down for the poor women's hospital, we just sat there and we were all adding bits of words to her. I don't think we've been on a nana trip yet on this one, so we haven't had a song about that.
That silver fox messing around. I wonder what she's up to in there. UK watching says hi.
Huh?
UK watching says hi.
Oh, hello.
Hey, hello.
Hello, UK.
The pigeons have just absolutely stuffed themselves silly on our cakes and biscuits. Just starting to rain here. Hope it doesn't get too bad. Hi.
You've got a charge of it for
that,
I've got
a couple as well, so yeah. Yeah, we've got to get the battery back up, I think.
Just go and go around the corner now.
Apparently someone trying to serve court papers on Tina Louise has followed us to London.
Oh, we
So that's why we're restarting the broadcast, a bit of excitement. Yeah, they're trying to serve the papers.
Did they manage to serve?
I don't know, don't think so. This whole thing is an absolute bloody fiasco. I'm sure the person doing it is getting lots of expenses for keeping on trying.
So a paper server just came to try and find me, and much like happened the last time where the guy in a stab vest came all the way to York to find me. They have my address, they can turn up at, you know, my sister's house, my daughter's house at any time they want to, but instead they sent a man all the way to London to serve papers. Now I only caught a bit of it before it got caught up in the wind and blew off, and apparently I have to serve 2 weeks in prison for contempt of court. But I need to go and defend myself on the 19th of October in court to face that charge, and I assume it will carry. But I'm just relieved that it's this, that at least it's till after the Lancashire decision. I want to see that through before we start dealing with my case. So yeah, so 19th of October, I'm assuming I'll be in court. But when I get back up to Blackpool, I'll phone the court and find out where we're up to.
Okay, thank you. So that's.
So that's the
update.
#IamTinaRothery
yeah,
court case.
Get that out, please. That's the latest update on the I Am Tina Rothery. They've tried to serve papers again to Tina. Someone came all the way down to London. Nice big fat expense claim, no doubt. And it's just started raining. Right, just let me put my brolly up. I've got it handy because this has been threatening for a while. Right. What? Yeah, thank you for that, UK watching. Yeah, that's the latest update for the IM Tina Rothery situation. This is absolutely outrageous that Quadrilla can try and pin absolutely enormous amount of legal costs on something which never actually happened. They're just taking the piss, and they must not be allowed to get away with it. It's a total, total abuse of our legal system. Yeah, it's just a way to deter activists. But if we join together, we can show it for what it is and laugh in their face. I just wonder how people that work for such despicable organisations can sleep at night. That's just my question. Is the paycheck worth it? Really? Is it worth it? Wouldn't you feel better if you just handed in your notice? If you work for scum like Quadrilla. Britain really needs earthquakes. People can say, well, did the earth move for you? Yeah, of course it did. We've got fracking. We want to be more like Oklahoma. Now it's actually rained, we might get a bit of bright sky for the rest of the afternoon.
It's gone a bit funny in the
end. The words of the song are, tonight we are going to dance for the first time. Well, yeah,
you're
going
to dance for the
I know I shall have an hour, but I'll share a room. I know another song.
That's the one everyone.
I think Noob, sorry. I think Noob.
No,
what? Noob, Noob. She turns her head past sometimes and I get this like dread because I get this. She's got a
dreadlash.
What are you doing now,
mate? Dreadlash.
Let's go around. Right, so if you go back to the start of this broadcast, if you joined it, we have the latest update on the IM Tina Rothery court fiasco, where Quadrilla is trying to pin her on, I think it's £50,000 worth of cost, or it's probably gone up by now, with all these attempts to send bailiffs down all the way down to London. He probably travelled first class even, so how many hundreds of pounds extra is that added to Quadrilla's bill that they're trying to get Tina Louise to pay? This whole thing is an absolute farce. Anyway, I'm going to shut down again now to save the battery, because the battery in this phone is not doing too well today. I'm down to under 50% already. So I'm saving it for later. So I'll be back in a bit.
Show!
Oh, now let's share!
It's wonderful!
It's wonderful!
Welcome back!
Share is wonderful! It's full of crack, fighting manners! Oh, now let's share is wonderful!
So, Nanas, shall we discuss what we now plan? It's now, what, 5:30? We did say we were going to come in and we get it. And we wanted to do that.
Yeah.
Because we could get settled there, put some luggage around this side, and at least sit down, have a little bit of music. We think we can without getting in so much trouble because we were kind enough to do from the monument. Yeah. So they said they might not notice the banners if we did them along that where those little pillory things are, I guess. So I think we move it this side of the pillars.
Are we thinking about going on the grass? What do we think?
That bit of grass there?
You have to be on the other side of the gates for the banners and things. But it still comes under the Royal Park police. They may stop.
Did they say the other side of the wall?
The other side of the gate.
They knew we were this side of the gate.
I think she's got the banners. They're going up, mate. They're going up.
See what happens. Let's go.
Stop you inside the gate. Stop you inside the park because it comes under the Royal Park police. And they are separate from the Royal Park. Like they did in Parliament Square. You're not allowed to have sleeping in fruit room. You're not allowed to have fallings. You're not allowed
Are there any more rabbits?
Even though that's what Parliament Square is about.
Okay. Parliament Square was actually put there for people that were Speaker's Corner. And now you're not allowed to protest there. Ridiculous.
That's because we've got a criminal government.
And you're over there to sleep. Hey, Olivia,
they're not allowed to sleep there.
We are.
And I forgot my skirt
again.
I'm so annoyed.
And then they come out of
Yeah, it does make it a lot more.
You're not allowed any sleeping equipment.
No, but then I have quite a good poncho.
You're not wearing a onesie,
the pizza box.
No, that's fucking impossible. There's no way. Unless you've got one of those ones like on Fall Back.
I was full of pieces and we were sat on the boxes and they took the mufflers on. They ripped the bloody tarpaulin from the old buns and then, so it was called the tarpaulin revolution. Occupied democracy. So me and Alfie went and slept on over the road on a piece of grass outside the Institute of Surveyors. And that wasn't in my remit. So about 30 people came over, even put tents up and everything. We had tents until the morning. Other police came and moved us on and we slept there the night. Me and Alfie didn't even have a tent.
Wait, Julie, wait. We weren't finished the meeting, darling, about whether everyone's content to leave the spot and go over there.
She's gone. You have to have a vote.
Come say it. Back here.
You in it.
Right,
Nanas.
Form yourself
an
opinion.
We've
got 3 minutes.
Going
over there.
See you later.
Bye, Julie.
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 Generally.
So what
are
we deciding?
So
we're
going to
follow you.
Nobody wants to go. Gang, we really need to pay attention to each other. Nobody wants to go inside the park because we lose our visibility. And the point is to be visible to that. This is the primary viewing point, but it will be a certain amount of even more discomfort through the night. There we could lay blankets and sit.
And the cars.
Yeah, and more requirements were better over by the park. And then this evening, we can come back across and sit here if we choose to. Let's go put our things there, set a base camp, and then be wherever we want to be. Yeah, Julie, so we'll set up base camp, and then we'll be whatever we want to be. Let's go, that's base camp.
So everyone leaving work now, head for Buckingham Palace. The Queen's not at home. All those bedrooms empty. All those bedrooms empty. The Queen's not at home even. And they won't accept post for her at the gate. It's got to be sent by the not any more royal mail. You can't deliver things at the gate, they've told us. No hand delivery.
Choppy, choppy.
Are you
Your kids, you know, three.
I was talking about woman you ain't got about the kids. I went, what kids? My kids, I'm trying to message you. I'm saying,
all right, heading to the new base camp. Fortunately, I've got a day return ticket, so I can't stay the night. But if somebody else, they say that 4 out of 5 adults in the UK now has a smartphone. So if you're one of those 4 out of 5, all you need to do this is get yourself an external battery and a selfie stick if you want to be able to broadcast a bit more comfort, and you can come do this. Anyone can do this. So I've been doing it for 5 years. But anyone can do it. It's not an exclusive club. Doesn't require special skill. A steady hand is handy, and that's about it. I use Bambooza. Other streaming services are available. Bambooza's handy because everything instantly gets recorded on servers up in Sweden. It leaves the country the second it's broadcast, which means there's absolutely no point in police and other officious bullies smashing people's phones. I think you say, in all cases, it would make matters 1,000 times worse. Actually, they can't destroy the evidence that way. How can one woman and a family need all this, plus multiple other palaces? Not right. So it's a request going out. We need someone to cover the evening shift with the nanas. Come on.
Abiding citizens and move to the other side of the road. I think the banner ain't so hard.
Wait.
Oh, the hot water's arrived.
Yeah,
thank you.
Oh. Then there's rum and tea and coffee.
Oh,
She's got her head scarf on, everybody.
We beseech you, ma'am, ban fracking by royal command.
Man out of the way, Maury.
Sorry.
No, I didn't know you were doing that. I just thought.
Oh. Genius use of shopping trolleys. The honks now. Now people are seeing the banners. Spread the word to Londoners. Come to Buckingham Palace.
I hope you can put it on.
All these passing taxis, all this passing traffic.
Oh!
It doesn't work. Lovely photo of the Queen. That should be on the £5 note.
Just receive notification from park officers, banners cannot be.
On the park.
Just fine. Just
PC Wheeler.
PC Wheeler, right?
Yeah. Hi, Andrew, nice to meet you.
And I think the point is that these people have just travelled hundreds and hundreds of miles.
Okay.
If you're holding them, as far as I'm aware, make statements about what you're doing to our planet.
As far as I'm aware, if you are holding them, and you're not completing them right now.
So we're not
is about having a piece of
when actually the issue was that state here is much bigger than having a piece of
I appreciate everything you're saying, and I appreciate that there are far bigger agendas going on than, as you just described, perhaps just a bit of cloth on a bit of a wall. But I'm just informing you that park officers have just told us on the radio.
But who employed, I mean, who are they looked after by?
And why do they care more about a piece of cloth on the wall than our air and water being poisoned?
They've asked us.
Is it a bylaw or a
law?
Yeah, but is it a bylaw?
That I don't know, because it's not my
specialty.
It's not a bylaw. They're bylaws for like your local common or whatever.
Like Trafalgar Square.
They're bylaws. However, there are laws that are set down about Royal Parks. Royal Parks, Spring Park, St. James Park, High Park. It's got its own legal. It's an offence for which you can be fined a quantity of money.
Yeah.
And if you're not going to comply, I'm going to do that to you.
If you don't provide
your details for the purpose of that fine, you can be arrested. It's similar to a bylaw.
If you don't give your details, you'll be in there. Is there any way the police compromise?
As far as I'm aware, I'm saying this isn't 100% true because I'm not an expert on park regulation, but the park is people stand holding them. As far as I'm aware, that's allowed.
They don't want them attached.
Because it's affixing things to park.
Can it lean against it as long as it's not attached? Because that's not even anywhere near.
I don't want to give you an answer because I'm not
but it's not attached, is it?
No, there are parks officers coming down who know.
So we need volunteers coming from all over London, please, to come and help hold these banners. Come on, Londoners. We need lots of volunteers to come and help hold these banners. 10,000 people to take turns holding these banners would be very nice. Come on. Come on, London, spread the word.
I don't know how clear or unclear they may have been with that instruction, but we were over there, we've just spoken on the radio.
Spread the word. We want 10,000 volunteers to come and hold these banners. New viewers, welcome. We need 10,000 volunteers to come and help hold these banners because we're not allowed to attach them to the park wall, apparently. That is much more important than poisoning our ground and our air and our water. Gaffer tape on park walls is more important. That's more important. To London officials, that's more important than poisoning our air, poisoning our water.
I know where all the cake is.
That is more important. That is a heinous crime.
More cake. Bring the cake down. Grandma needs more cake and make it. It's going to be a long night.
Come on, London. Head down here.
Tesco collar.
There's definitely an offensive affixing banners to I don't know if there's an offensive displaying a banner with a police car.
I'll do it.
Yeah. You're hiding.
She's changed her mind. Like, come here then, Lily. Banners. Come here.
There is quite a process of course. Yes, however.
Royal Park has got all the good playing music that can be heard from like 30 centimetres away.
Because there's only a limited number of park boxes, we don't know. How do they know that we've been here? Cameras? No, we were over there, we were just patrolling.
I just checked up with the office.
Did you grass on them?
I checked with the park unit if they were aware there was a protest because you're in a Royal Park area, they have to be aware there's a protest.
Where is the Queen? Can we go and bother her where she is?
Windsor.
Windsor? That's what I thought.
Well, officer, can I ask you a polite question?
You can ask a polite question, you might get an answer.
Where is she?
I honestly don't know.
He can't tell you if you don't.
Either me.
Well, we were serving to the guy.
Come on, let's think as we are, just to kill the park warden.
No, it's not interesting telling us. I recommend Windsor.
Yeah, people near Windsor. I've said the word near Windsor. Let's set up this at every single royal residence.
Is anybody watching? Can we send somebody to see if she's at Windsor?
Yes. Yeah, anyone in Windsor? And all the other royal palaces. Let's keep it up, all of them. Until we get an end to this insanity. So we need volunteers. We need lots of volunteers to come and help hold these banners up, because that's all we're allowed to do. More volunteers required. Get your ass down to Buckingham Palace. Spread the word. Sorry? Yes, going out live now.
Explain what's going on, yeah?
Yeah.
So the officers over there, if you've been watching the live stream, whoever you are, you'll know that the officer has been told by the local parks wardens that they need to tell us to get our banners off the wall.
Yes.
So we're standing here now with the banners in our hands to let passers by know what we're up to. We've already been kicked out from over there.
Yeah.
And that's what's going on. But some people are not happy to take them off the wall because they're not hurting anybody. You know, that piece of concrete has not been hurt by that piece of silver tape that I just
took. It's nothing like fracking fluid, is it?
It
leaves no trace.
Exactly, it's nothing like fracking fluid. So it's all a bit sad, really.
Yeah, spread the word. Spread the word, we need volunteers. Need more people here. Oh, that's standing up quite nicely, actually. Well, is that an offence? It leaning? Is it an offence for any object to lean against the park wall? Maybe we need a mass lean. Maybe we need to surround all royal parks with people leaning against the walls.
I'll do it straight away, but I see you on a lot of my
Are we taking, shall I take that one down?
No, let them just come and take them down.
Let them start it.
I'll come to 30 minutes, so I'll be right back. Welcome back. We're on the outside boundary of Green Park, next to Buckingham Palace, where the Queen is not in residence because the Royal Standard isn't there. We've been told that we're not allowed to attach banners to the park walls even. It's against some stupid bylaw. What's an irony that people who look after parks are more concerned about things being attached to concrete walls that have been here for God knows how long and not concerned about the poisoning of our land, our air and our water by these criminals that our government, our criminal government, is supporting. Call out to everyone in London. We need people to come and take turns in holding these banners. If we had 10,000 people here overnight holding the banners, that would create quite a stir, wouldn't it? Come on, London. They've got a banner. They've got a banner. Who? What are they doing with that banner? The banner police need to go get them. Who are they with the banner? We're going to get some final sunshine of the day. Nana's picnic. So Silver Fox is broadcasting as well now. And this is the most sunshine we've had all day. Amazing! Just starting to come through.
Danke, David. Nice to have viewers from Germany. At least this time, David, you haven't used my bloody real name.
Not necessarily. Is that what you're saying? Happy days.
I'm sure there's some milk somewhere.
We've got more police have arrived.
If you want to have a demonstration, you need to arrange it. I think we're starting to enter into an argument that I don't want to have. I'm not taking any attitude. All I'm saying, I haven't got a problem with you holding the banner. It's the police just trying to fix it.
Right, okay, let me just take some down. In front of you, do what the law says.
want to know why Cruz is.
I wish I could. She's never here.
Well, if the Queen is never there, why not turn it into a hostel, for the homeless? What's the point? The Queen never needs it.
Unfortunately, I have no power in any government legislation.
Are you saying he agrees with
that? I'm just a mere place
officer.
Duct tape, we're not allowed duct tape. But remember, it's not spelled D-U-C-K, it's spelled D-U-C-T. And it's from air conditioning ducts.
It's not for ducks.
I've always called it duct tape.
All those years, You've
been taping ducts in your ceiling.
Ducts apart.
Ducts on air. D-U-C-T, it's duct tape.
See, now,
see, the things you learn on live stream. What's Janelle doing?
I'll sue them, the parks police.
Good on that one as well. It got pretty saucy this summer. We had knife with robberies. Well, you know what? She doesn't have to see it.
Can you catch the show?
Don't imagine. Mine's always been rubbish.
What about you, officer?
It
is, it's been done over, isn't it? What about pensions now, please?
He looks older than he is.
You're a baby. You're like,
Oh, you need the key. You still need the key. Yeah, but then it takes about 10 minutes for the computer to start up.
You've got some.
Who's your phone? Your computer. Yeah, they need to send me jobs to go to.
Yeah, but if you're not in it, you can't see the computer.
Dear Your Majesty, these are my granddaughters.
If it's an urgent call, I've got like 10 minutes to find out.
Isn't it lovely?
Yeah.
No equipment, no pensions.
Yeah, it was not a really happy day for you when you saw the new Prime Minister, was it? No comment. Just leave what we didn't know. No comment. That's the best thing to say. No comment.
That is true.
It is. You just aren't allowed an opinion when you're on duty anyway, are you?
Yeah, but you just
can't really express it.
You can tell you when you're on duty. Get in trouble.
We've been fighting a very long battle with her.
If I got arrested, and you took me down the nick, I would, and one of them G4S, I would not let them anywhere near me. If I
If I get arrested by a copper, yeah,
make sure
I'm going to be processed by a copper, right? Not
yeah,
G4S.
Yeah, you get processed by him.
No, I'm looking.
Look
no, jot it down just in case.
There's a documentary on the
this is 10 more.
Thank you very much.
Well,
thanks. Thanks.
Everyone knows it.
Thanks.
Lucky,
so I bet they're out trundling the way to Windsor or something, yeah. Going out shooting.
If I find out the Queen is making money out of anyone's fucking.
That's what they do for fun. In the winter, in the
kills.
Summer.
Kill
I love shooting the bloody deer.
Yeah, no, I know that. If I find out anyone in the royal family is making money out of this lot, laugh it.
Hey, no, but there is summer. I do want to know. Fox hunting. It's not legal, is it? It's been banned, isn't it, fox hunting?
You don't get much
fox hunting for a while. You go down in Surrey and that's still doing fox hunting. And it's an eagle on the top
of the
hill doing it all.
I've got a
Charles does.
Prince
Charles does. He goes down in Sussex.
And he tells me that they're still in London. That's what they do for fun, go out kill things.
I need to make
decisions. I bet you're
dead glad to come round here, aren't you? You're very charming, you're not offensive like that.
No,
you're
not. We're not like it. It's
Can't make rules.
That's not really.
It would be immoral to treat people differently.
No, it's not fair to stop people from having the enjoyment of not really causing a problem.
But where do you draw the line?
Well, what you do is, you have a rule that says, you can't play any offensive music.
What is offensive though?
Well,
it's swearing. That's not the rule, which is no.
So
the rule for music out here is that you can't play music at all. No music. I don't get it. Music's a happy thing.
Yeah.
Happy people behave better. Let's get speakers out. You know?
Yeah. And the music isn't as loud as it's even a passing car, is it?
You love it. The music's getting to you. Break out in some street dances in a minute.
No, the problem is part treating it differently, it's like you said.
Oh, that's what
we're getting ready.
And they're different from others. And that's where we have to say, like, no one will do it. Because otherwise we get accused of being discriminatory. It's one of those. Even if I don't find the music offensive, if I then find someone else's music offensive or it tends to be loud, etc., I can't say to them, well, you need to turn yours off when I've just let someone else have theirs. And it's one of those, unfortunately.
I'm going to try and stay up all night.
What time are you guys here till?
Right, I need someone to take over. I'm just going to say my goodbyes because I'm only on a day ticket and my battery is down to less than 30% as well. So even if I wanted to, we'd only be able to broadcast another 20 minutes or so. So the nanas are going to be here overnight, that's the plan. So please join them. Spread the word to people in London. It's a very pleasant September evening. We're outside Buckingham Palace. So spend your Tuesday evening on the grass. There's tea and cakes. Hello, if someone can bring some more hot water, that would be nice. That's going to run out. Just look at these cakes. Before I go, just look at these really fancy cakes.
Yeah, go 22%.
Can you open the lid on those so I can just take the cakes? Just take a picture of these absolutely wonderful cakes. Very regal.
Aren't they?
Cakes with tiaras.
Yes.
And royal crests.
Strawberries.
Yeah.
Have we offered these in one?
So I'm just trying to encourage more people, trying to encourage London to come down. We're here overnight. I unfortunately have to go.
Thanks very much. Have a good night.
Yes.
Oh, they
yeah. Tina, unfortunately I have to go. My battery's nearly dead as well. But I have told people to come down, to come for the lovely cakes and bring hot water. Yeah.
Your partner's been watching on your live stream.
Yes.
She's really enjoyed it.
All right, yeah, okay.
Cheers, Mark.
Right, goodbye. Right. Right, I'm signing off now. If you want to see any more of this, you've got to come down. So, it's a lovely evening. Come on down, join the Fracking Nanas, and make a statement.